Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing well at your places and taking care of yourself. So let's start today's video lecture. As we have discussed in previous two lectures about the chapter number 4, National Movements in India. In part 1, we have discussed about the indigenous movement and Muslim League. And in part 2, we have discussed about the extreme revolutionary activities in India and Gujarat. So let's start today the next topic of this chapter, that is Rowlatt Act. As we know very well that Gandhiji arrived in India in 1915 from South Africa, and his political mentor was Gopal Krishna Gokhale and spiritual mentor was Srimad Raj Chandra. As Gandhiji arrived in India, he suddenly took the part in the Indian national movements, Indian freedom movements, and he took out the survey and visited all over the country, and he found that the reason behind the poverty is the British rule. So he started to make a plan for the abolishing British rule from the India. After a few years in 1919, under the chairmanship of Rowlatt, who was the law minister in the British government, he framed an act. According to this act, any suspicious person could be arrested or could be jailed without conducting any kind of trial against him. So, this act was considered as a black act. This act was considered as a black act by Mahatma Gandhiji, and Motilal Nehru also considered this as a snatching away of advocacy, appeal and arguments. So, as we know, according to this act, this act was clearly snatching away the freedom of speech of the Indian people. That's why Indian people decided to protest or oppose this act. Many rallies, strikes, assemblies were organized for the protest or for the oppose of this act. Gandhiji was arrested in Delhi during the protest, and Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Kichlu, they were also prominent leaders, they were arrested in Punjab. When these leaders were arrested, this agitation became more severe. And we will learn about the next topic, Jallianwala, which is directly connected with the Rowlatt Act. So this is all about the Rowlatt Act. Okay, let's have a gist again of Rowlatt Act. Rowlatt Act was framed in 1919 under the chairmanship of Rowlatt, who was the law minister. And according to this act, any suspicious person could be arrested or jailed without conducting any kind of trial against him. That's why Gandhiji considered this as a black act, and Motilal Nehru considered this as snatching away of argument, advocacy and appeal. That's why Indian people decided to oppose this act, and strikes, rallies and protests were organized, and Gandhiji was arrested in Delhi, and Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Kichlu were arrested in Punjab, and the agitation became more severe. So this is all about the Rowlatt Act. Now the next topic is Jallianwala Bagh Massacre. See, as we discussed in Rowlatt Act, that Satyapal and Dr. Kichlu were arrested in Punjab, that's why the Punjabi people decided to oppose their arrestment. That's why, on the day of Vaisakhi, on 13th April 1919, people gathered at Jallianwala Bagh, which is situated in Amritsar, Punjab. Okay, there is a misprint in your textbook. If it is written 13th March, please make the correction with 13th April. So, people gathered in Jallianwala Bagh on the day of Vaisakhi to oppose the arrestment of Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Kichlu. Now, well, we will discuss about the Bagh, or we will have a description of the Bagh. The Bagh, there were of high walls on four sides of the Bagh, and unused well on the middle of the Bagh, and there was only a narrow gate which is used for the entry and exit. Now at that time General Dyer reached to the bar and he set up his troop on that entry or exit gate which is being narrow, was very narrow, so no one can go outside. And without any kind of warning, General Dyer ordered to open fire on innocent people with machine gun. And his troops followed his order and they started open firing on the innocent people. In this inhuman, or we can say cruel act, many people lost their lives. Many people jumped into the well to protect themselves, but you will get shot. After the firing, 150 dead bodies were recovered from that well only. Well, it is not in your textbook, but I am just sharing the information. 150 dead bodies were recovered from that unused well. According to the British report, 379 people died and 1200 people injured seriously. But when Congress investigated this massacre, they found 1000 people died in this inhuman act or in this merciless act. Under commission was appointed for the investigation deeply on this massacre, but they defend General Dyer. They forgive the General Dyer and consider this that it is an innocent mistake that was happened unknowingly. So by the judgment of the Hunter Commission, Indian people terribly shocked. And when General Dyer returned to the England, he was honored with a sword and 2000 pounds. So after hearing this news, Gandhiji's faith towards the Britishers completely lost. And this event played an important role in the unity to the united whole nation, and it set a platform for the future non-cooperation movement. So this is all about the Jallianwala Bagh. The people arrested, the people gathered in the Jallianwala Bagh on the day of 13th April 1919 on the day of Baisakhi to oppose the arrestment of Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Kichlu. And General Dyer reached there and he started to open fire on the innocent people. According to the British report, 379 people died and 1200 people injured. But when Congress reinvestigated this massacre, 1000 people died in this act. Hunter Commission appointed for the investigation on the behalf of the British government, but they defend Dyer. They forgave Dyer and considered it as an innocent mistake that was happened unknowingly. When Dyer returned to the England, he was honored with a sword and 2000 pounds. So after hearing this, Indian got terribly shocked, and Gandhiji lost the faith towards the Britishers, and this event played an important role for the whole nation united and set a platform for the future non-cooperation movement. I hope you clearly understood what we have discussed, Rowlatt Act and Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Now we will discuss about the non-cooperation movement. Non-cooperation movement, that means what is the meaning of non-cooperation movement? Non-cooperation movement, that means to not cooperate with someone. Non-cooperation movement was started in 1920 to 1922. Now, resolution of non-cooperation was approved in the Nagpur conference in December 1920. Non-cooperation resolution was approved in Nagpur conference in December 1920. Now, the Congress demand for complete independence instead of self-governance. That means ki now India, the Congress was demanding for the Swaraj instead of Swashasan under the British rule. So let's start. See, first of all, before the starting, we will discuss about the two aspects of this movement. Those were constructive and negative. Constructive and negative aspects were there of this movement. In constructive aspects, that is also known as the positive aspects, we can consider which were the constructive aspects. So first of all, to Hindu-Muslim unity should be strengthened. Then abolish untouchability, collection of 1 crore rupees in Tilak Swaraj fund, insistence on adopting Swadeshi articles, revival of spinning wheels in every house, national education, prohibition. So these were the constructive aspects of this movement. And negative aspects, so we can consider negative aspects like giving up the government jobs, giving up the government schools and colleges, giving up your titles, ceremonies, resign from your post, we can say that anyone working in the self local government institute, so they all need to resign from their post. So these were the whole in negative aspects. We can also consider the boycott of foreign clothes and boycott of the foreign articles which were imported from the England. So all kind of boycotted or non-cooperate with the British government can be considered in the negative aspects of this movement. Now, we will discuss about the notable programs of non-cooperation movement. So, which incident took place during the non-cooperation movement? See, in the beginning of the movement, Mahatma Gandhiji and Rabindranath Tagore surrendered their title. Mahatma Gandhi surrendered his title Kesari Hind and Rabindranath Tagore surrendered his title Knight of Honor. Other prominent leaders were also resigned from their post. Students left the schools and colleges. Duke of Connacht, which arrived in India, it was also boycotted. Then ceremony of Prince of Wales was also boycotted. So this type of incidents create a national excitement, created a national excitement in the Indian peoples. Moreover, when we were adopting the national education, so we need to establish national schools and colleges. So at that point of time, 4 Vidyapeeths were established for the national education, which were there. So Kashi, Jamia Millia, Bihar and Gujarat Vidyapeeths were established during the non-cooperation movement to support the national education. Now, see, as we were boycotting the foreign goods and adopting the national articles or national goods or Swadeshi goods, that's why Britishers or British government were facing the huge economic loss. So this rattled the British Parliament. And everything was going according to our plan. Moreover, we have collected more than 1 crore rupees in the Tilak Swaraj fund. So everything was going smooth as butter. But what happened? So this movement couldn't get success. There was an important event took place for that. Gandhiji withdraw this movement. So let's talk about that. Chori Chora incident. Once a people took out the rally in the Chori Chora village, which is situated in Gorakhpur district of Uttar Pradesh. The rally was very peacefully manner. The rally was in very peacefully manner, but policemen opened fire on the rally. But when they ran short of bullets, they locked themselves inside the police station. The angry crowd attacked on the police station and set the whole police station on fire. And in this act, 21 policemen which were locked inside, they all died. Total 21 policemen died in this Chori Chora incident. When this news reached to the Gandhiji, Gandhiji was terribly shocked after hearing this horrible news, and he said, "I have committed a Himalayan blunder by giving the tool of Satyagraha to those people who do not understand the value of नॉन वायलेंस, दैट मींस कि मैंने सत्याग्रह जैसी ऐसी चीज ऐसे लोगों के हाथ में देकर हिमालय जैसी बड़ी भूल कर दी है कि जिनको अहिंसा की कीमत पता नहीं है. एंड गांधी जी इमीडिएटली सस्पेंडेड दैट मूवमेंट. सो आफ्टर चोरी चोरा इंसिडेंट गांधी जी इमीडिएटली सस्पेंडेड दिस मूवमेंट. So today we have discussed the three topics, and I suppose I am ending this chapter here only. We have discussed about the Rowlatt Act, Jallianwala Bagh, arrival of Gandhi ji. Also we have discussed that we have discussed about the non-cooperation movement. I hope you clearly understood what we have discussed today. If still you have any doubt, you can ask me in the live session, and I will also share the PDF of the same.